It's good to be here. I'm going to set some precedents right now. Now let me just say what I do. When I preach, Ellis Shade, I don't make apologies for what I preach.
Don't.
I hope you hear me.
This is true.
I don't make apologies. If the cap fit, you wear it. Now you gotta understand this. I don't preach to you. I preach to myself also. So you will be turned into we.
Right.
Are you understanding what I'm saying?
Yes.
Because we are all sinners. And Jesus died for all of us.
Yes.
And he's coming back to save all of us. But the bad thing about it is that some of us will choose not to be saved. Now let me say that again. If any one of us don't make it into the kingdom, it's because we choose not to make it in the kingdom. I want that to sink in. Because Jesus cannot save any one of us here against our will. He says, I've set before you life and death. And then hear what he did. The good part, Elder, I tell you, choose life.
Amen.
So the choice is up to us, Father in heaven. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, our strength, our Redeemer. Amen. Turn your Bibles to Exodus chapter 20. Exodus chapter 20. And we're going to fall. I know everybody knows what's there. Exodus chapter 20. I know you repeated it this morning, but I want you to see something. Before you look in your Bibles, let's all repeat verse 11 together. It starts 4 and 6 days. Don't look in the Bible. Just repeat it.
4 and 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth,
the sea,
and all that in them is, and rested on the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it.
Now look in your Bibles and repeat it and say it.
4 and 6 days the Lord made
earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and
rested on the seventh day.
Stop right there. Now let me say this, your church is not unique in this. Almost every church put in the word on the seventh day. Right there, the world conclude that Jesus just rested on the seventh day of that week alone. To say on the seventh day. But when you say he rested the seventh day.
Amen.
Are you understanding what I'm saying, Elder?
Amen.
Are you understanding? If you don't understand, let's talk about it.
Amen.
When you say Jesus rested on the seventh day, it is construed by the world that it's just that week that he was talking about. But when you say he rested the seventh day, it doesn't change. You see, these little things is slipped by us.
Yes.
Now it would be hurtful to me, and I'd be disobeying the Lord if I didn't say that this morning. Because I heard it. I had to correct my children, because by this saying this is our affirmation of faith in church, people just garner it like this is what the Bible is saying. The last person who added something to God's Bible got us in trouble. That's why we're here now.
Mm.
It's a is not my message, but I'm just letting us understand what's going on. Because this is how deception easily set in. And we don't see it. See, if we put a blue cloth up here, everybody will see that it's a blue cloth. Isn't that true?
Yes, sir.
But if we put something that look like a blue cloth, we will always look at it and say it's a blue cloth when it's not. Because deceptions are something that appears to be the same.
Yes, yes, yes.
See, Eve uttered certain words that God did not say.
Yes.
Satan posed the question. Hadn't God say you're not supposed to eat of it? Watch the devil and his smartness. See? I don't want to leave what I came here to talk about, but this is how it creeps upon us. Mm-hmm. Watch Satan. Satan quotes and misquotes. So adding a little truth to a lie make it look like it's true. Am I speaking the truth?
Yes, yes, yes.
And what he said to Eve, hath not God said you should not eat of this fruit, lest you die? He quote accurately. But Eve, being zealous of good works, want to see what God says. He says, yeah, God says we're not supposed to touch it or eat of it, lest we die. God never said don't touch it. If you look in your Bible,
never said that.
God never uttered the word touch. And Ellen White says, the moment she echoed the word touch, Satan picked the fruit and gave it to her. And she took it and he says, you just said, God says if you touch it, you'll die. Did you die? Spirit of prophecy speaking plain. And Eve started to say, yes, I did not die. I did not die. Then she started believing what Satan says about God. Doubt started. One single word makes a difference. Thou shalt not surely die. Did you hear that? Why am I here? That's my message. Just wanted to point that out. So let's be careful when we read the scripture that we quote the scripture accurately. Because it was put in place by the third person of the Godhead. Holy men of God spake as they were moved. That word move means they were taught and inspired what to say. Repeat what to say God says. Because no matter how many degrees we have, we still have to come back to God.
Amen.
See, the Bible is not a student. The words of God is a teacher.
Yes.
And
yes,
we are students.
Hallelujah.
So we come to learn from a teacher.
Yes.
Are you understanding what's going on?
Yes.
Why am I here? Jesus says, all power in heaven and in earth. Let's break that down, Elder. Is heaven packed up with power?
Oh, yeah.
Come on, brethren. Oh, where did Lucifer come from?
Heaven.
Did Lucifer have power?
Yes.
Does Lucifer have power today?
Yes.
When his name changed, did God remove any power? Catching this? Because he had a name change doesn't mean that anything was taken from him or anything was given to him. Elder, if you go down to City Hall now and change your name, is anything taken away from you bodily? As a matter of fact, all you did was take a pen and write on a piece of paper and have your name changed. Satan being changed. Lucifer means light bearer. Lucifer, son of the morning. You see, when all the other angels were made elevated, you see, God called them into existence. And let me drop the scene. God was there. God was there. And God was there.
Yes, 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 yes.
In other words, the Godhead was the active workers in creation. And we have the lessons now being telling us that the Holy Spirit was a part of creation. So let me just let you understand. Let us understand what we are up against. So God was there. God was there.
Yes.
And God was there.
Yes, yes, yes.
And God number two. We can do the work. But we need some messengers around. God number one. All right. God number three, bring them into existence.
Yes,
Ellen White says, God number three says, let there be. And all of a sudden, thousands, millions of angels just come from anywhere.
Wow.
Elevator. Like they were there in existence before. Power. We're talking about power. And then God wanted another angel. We're talking about power. Watch where I'm going. The topic of my message is, why am I here? And the Godhead says, call another angel into existence. Don't be too lazy to read the Spirit of Prophecy.
Amen.
Dig it up. It's the blueprint of behind the scenes of what the Bible wrote.
Yes, yes.
Now you get what I'm saying?
Yes, yes.
Now, why did God give us that? The children of Israel were God's chosen nation.
Yes.
What were they to do? Tell the world who God is. We are God's Israelites today.
Yes.
And he has given us the inside scope of what happened. But you know what? We have become so lazy like the Egyptians.
Mercy.
And the Babylonians. That whatever Robinson says up here, that's good enough for me. No. They search the scriptures daily. You understand, brother? Those men, when someone preached to them, they didn't say, let me take it up monthly and see. They searched the scriptures daily. In other words, to measure what was being said, if it's coming from God's word. And we have become so lazy today. And watch this. All appears to Lucifer in heaven. The most handsome of all the angels. The most decorated of all the angels.
Yes.
The most powerful.
Yes.
Of all the angels. Spirit of Prophecy says, God says to Lucifer, you answer to God number three. But in the meantime, Elder, he could walk into God's royal presence.
Yes.
None of the other angels could do that. As a matter of fact, Spirit of Prophecy says, Ella Victor, she says he was like God number four. Because God made him as much as possible like himself. God put everything in him. More than what he put in the other angels. Are you catching?
Yes,
what
yes.
What what chapter in the Bible could be given to describe this being? He's got to be important. Read about him in Ezekiel 28. If a whole chapter is dedicated to introducing and describing a certain angel, he's important. In other words, Elder, we are not dealing with any fool. He walked through the Garden of Eden. He stepped on all of those precious stones. He was glowing like Jesus. Watch those words. Glowing like Jesus. What I'm telling you, go read about it. He was not a jewel, but he glowed like precious jewels. Catch that? He's not a lion, but he's roaring like a lion. Now, who is the lion? Jesus is the lion of the tribe of Judah. When the Bible says he's barking like a roaring lion, don't miss the word like. He's like a lion. He's not a lion. He's not a jewel. He just glows like a jewel. And you get that glowing power, or that glowing look, from being in the presence of God. When we stand in the presence of God, we can't help but glow.
Amen.
Am I lying?
No, Moses.
Did Moses go up to heaven?
Yes.
To collect the what? The two tablets, and what happened when he was coming back? Spent 40 days. No. That number.
Yes.
You see that number, brethren? You see that number? I tell you another time when I come here, we just go deal with the 40s. So many things are connected to the number 40. So many.